Welcome to my channel. If you like my videos, then kindly subscribe, like and watch. Thank you. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Today we will start with the topic that is bending moment of member made up of several materials. So in this case we can see that we have a beam that is made up of two material. So this is the beam and having made up of material one. Clear, and this is the material 2. So those beams that are made up of several materials are known as composite material. So this is composite beam that is made up of material 1 and material 2. So this material 1 will have modulus of elasticity E1 and this material 2 having modulus of elasticity E2. As we know that stress is equal to modulus of elasticity into strain. So we can see that stress is a material property. So stress in material 1 will be different and stress in material 2 will be different. So consider a composite beam formed from two material E1 and E2 as shown in the figure. So in this type of problems or in this composite beams, it is very difficult to find the centroid of this beam. So there is a method to solve such type of problem. So before going that, I will explain some basic things. As we know that stress is equal to E into epsilon, and we also know that stress in beam is equal to MC over I. This is for maximum stress, and for stress at any point is minus MY over I. So in such type of beam, composite beams, that is subjected to movement. So definitely there will be a bending. If there is a there is a decrease in length in the upper layer above the neutral axis, so it will be under compression. And if the neutral if the surface below the neutral axis is in elongation, then there will be a tensile stress. But that depend on the direction of movements. Clear? So as from this general formula, the stress distribution in this such composite beam is given over here. I will explain it as well over here. So for example, we have two beams that is made up of two material, composite material. For example, this is one and there is another material that is two. So this is one, this is two. And in such type of composite material, it is very difficult to find the centroid or neutral axis in this beams. So this neutral axis may come in material 1 or it may come in material 2. For example, if the neutral axis is in material 2, in such type of cases we are going to find the stress distribution. For example, this is a neutral axis and this is the vertical line. So you can see by using the formula, sigma is equal to my over I. There is a negative sign. Clear? So for material 1, you can see that if y is equal to 0, so stress will be 0 at this point. And stress will be maximum at this point. But this will be the maximum and compressive one. Similarly, if you go to this point, there will be some stress, and this point there will be stress, and so on. So this is the stress distribution in the first portion. Clear? Now this is minus sigma, which means that this the upper portion is in compression. Now for point material 2, you can see there are some portion of the second material is above the neutral axis and rest is below. So this portion above will also will be negative. So this is the neutral axis. So at this point it will be like this and it will come to zero like this. And for further portion it will be toward this positive, because now it is going toward the toward tension side. So this is the stress distribution that is shown over here. So you can see that for first portion that is under compression, sigma 1 is equal to E1 over Y over rho. As we know that sigma is equal to E into epsilon, and this epsilon in x direction is equal to Y over rho. Clear? That is epsilon in x direction is equal to minus Y over rho. So sigma is equal to minus E Y over rho. Material 1, this sigma is equal to minus E1 Y over rho 1, and the distribution is shown over here. So it's starting from 0 because neutral axis is this one, for example. So from Y is equal to 0, stress will be 0, and Y will be maximum at outer surface. So this is the distribution. If I zoom it over here, so this is the maximum. So this is distribution for first material. Now for second material, you can see that some material is above the neutral axis, so Y will be definitely above value, that will be positive value. So if you put in this, so that will give you negative value. So it means that some portion of the material 2 above the neutral axis is also in compression. When the neutral axis reaches, so definitely the stress will be 0, because if Y is equal to 0, so stress will be 0. Now if you move downward further below the neutral axis, so you can see Y will become negative. So if you put the Y negative, the stress will be positive, and the stress will be maximum at the outermost surface. So stress in this portion is positive, means that sigma 2 is in tension. So this is the formula for finding the stress at in material 1, that is minus E 1 Y over rho, and this is for stress in the material 2, that is also minus E 2 Y over rho. So if you put the value of Y in this equation, you will get the stress in material 1 and material 2. Clear? So this is generally a stress distribution in composite material. Now let's start how to tackle a beam that is made up of more than one material. So consider a composite beam formed from two material E1 and E2, and we also know that normal strain Ex epsilon x is equal to minus Y over rho. So you can see from first material we have stress is equal to sigma 1, that is equal to E1 over epsilon x. And if you put the value of epsilon x from here, so sigma 1 will be equal to minus E1 Y over rho 2. Similarly, sigma 2 is equal to E2 into epsilon x, and if you put the value of epsilon x, then stress in material 2 is equal to minus E Y over rho. Now in this case, the neutral axis does not pass through section centroid of composite material, and it is very difficult to find the neutral axis of the composite material. So what we will do is that we will divide, or we will convert this beam into transform section. Now what is transform section? In transform section, what we do is we convert the material of 2 into 1. We will replace material 2 with material 1, or material 1 with material 2, so that it becomes a beam that is made up of single material, and then we will solve it by using our technique that we discussed in earlier problem. So let's start with conversion of composite beam into a single material beam. So let this is the beam that is having width B. Clear? B. This is material 1, this is material 2. Now you have taken a small differential area A. This. Similarly, you can also take a small differential area A in the upper material. So this is dA. So force in this element, this is for example first element dA1, and this is two element. So the force on this smaller area will be equal to dF1. Similarly, the force in this smaller differential area of second material will be equal to dF2. So now elemental force on this section dF1 is equal to dF1 is the force acting on small differential area of material 1, and this is differential area will be equal to stress into area. stress into differential area dA. Here, let me zoom it also. So this will be in first material, so df1 will be equal to sigma 1 into dA1. Similarly, for this smaller differential force in the second material, this area, this df2 will be equal to sigma 2 into dA2, which is also mentioned over here. So elemental force in the section are df1, which is equal to sigma 1 into dA1, and elemental force df2 in material 2 is sigma 2 into dA. Also, we know that stress is equal to E over minus E over Y over rho, which is mentioned above here. Clear? So putting the value of sigma 1 will be equal to E1 Y over rho, and the remaining thing will be the same, minus E1 Y over rho into dA, and df2 will become equal to E2 Y over rho into dA minus. So these are the forces in material 1 and material 2. Now we have to transform this beam, composite beam, into a single material beam. For that we will describe a term that is N, and this N is the ratio of two material modulus, for example E2 over E1. Now N is the ratio of modulus of elasticity of second material over modulus of elasticity of first material. So it's a number having no unit. So from this equation we can see that E2 is equal to NE1. We can also take E1 over E2. You can take it as well, but till now it is recommended that to use higher modulus in numerator and lower modulus in denominator. So a material having higher modulus should be taken in upper numerator, and lower value is taken as denominator. We can also take the lower in upper and higher in the lower, but this effect will be clear to you in a while. So let's, N is equal to E2 over E1, where E2 is the modulus of elasticity of material 2 and E1 is the modulus of elasticity in of material 1. So E2 is equal to N times E1. Clear? So up till now we discuss df1 is this and df2 is this. Now to convert this composite material into a single material, we will replace E2, this E2, by this equation. So if you put E2 is equal to NE1, so DF2 will become equal to minus in place of E2, that is NE1, and the rest thing will be the same, Y over rho into dA. So if you take this E1 Y over rho minus over here, and that will be equal to N into dA. So what does it mean? It means that if you change the material E2 with E1, so what will happen? You have to, the area of the second portion should increase N times. So this is how we have shown, they have shown over here, that this is the material 1 that is of the same B and height. Clear? And now this material 2 is replaced with this area. Clear? So you can see that the area is NDA. Okay, let me explain one more thing, that N into DA means that area is increased. Now area of rectangle, as you know, that area of rectangle A is equal to B into H. Clear? So if area increases N time A is equal to N time B into H. So here you have provision to increase the B, but you cannot change H, because if you change H, so height will increase and our centroidal axis or neutral axis may disturb. We do not want to change the neutral axis, the location of neutral axis. So the solution is that only you can change B. So breadth will increase N time. So height is the same, and this area has been changed in by increasing breadth to end time. So this portion is converted into this portion. Height remains same, only breadth change. So this material 2 is transformed into material 1. This section, this area, or this is equivalent to this. Now this complete composite beam is transformed into a beam that is of single material. Now this is also material 1 and this is also a material 1, but shape change, only shape changes. So now we will solve this further by using our concept that we discussed in previous section. Rest the same thing is this is same as we studied earlier. Now you can see you have changed this beam into a beam that is made up of single material, so it's easy to find the centroid of single beam by using same formula. Y dash is equal to sum of y dash into a plus, yes, divided by sum of area. So you can find I by using this formula, y dash by using this formula, and then you can find moment of inertia. Once you find the moment of inertia and y dash, you can calculate the maximum stress, that is equal to mc over I. So moment will be given in the problem. C is the distance of from centroid to the outermost. You can also find that, and I you can also calculate for this beam. This is how we will solve a composite beam under the moment load. Again I will repeat, so in composite materials or in composite beam, you have to convert you have to convert it into transform beam of having one material. So you will have n is equal to e2 over e1, so e will be equal to n e1, and the, if you replace the material 2 with material 1, so area of material 2 will enhance by n times of dA. Clear? And then you will convert it into a beam of single material. Now this is transform beam. So we will see how to solve such problem. We will have a sample problem. So let's start with that problem and then we will move toward. Again, you can see this is an example 4.0 regarding a composite beam. So you can see that this is the beam bar that is made up of bonded pieces of steel and brass. Modulus of elasticity of steel is given and modulus of elasticity of bar is also given. So you have to determine the maximum stress in steel and brass when a moment of 40 kips is applied. Clear? So again you can see this is steel, this is brass. So first you have to transform the bar into equivalent cross section that is made up of entire brass. So for that, what will you do? You have to find n, and n is equal to larger e, which is e of steel, divided by e of brass. So you will get any value. So from that value, so what will you do? That value will increase the transform, will cause this beam to transform into a single material, so the area will increase. Clear? Then equivalent cross-sectional properties of transform section we will see in a while, and then we will calculate the stress in transform beam. This is the correct maximum stress of brass pieces, and then you have to determine the stress in steel as well as in brass. One thing that I have missed in the above topic is that when you find the stress in this maximum stress in this, so that will be the stress in this material 1. So for material 2, that will be equal to n times sigma m1. So this is how you will able to find the maximum stress in material 2. Now we will solve this problem, and after solving this problem you will definitely understand how to solve problem that is related to composite material. So now in this figure you can see this was our given beam that is made up of composite material. The total height of this beam is 3 inch. Now you can see that this is a rectangular beam, so definitely half of 3 will be 1.5, which is the center of this beam. So first step is to transform the bar into equal cross section made up of entirely brass. So what will you do? You use N is equal to E of steel over EB, modulus of elasticity of bar. So E of steel is 29 into 10 to the power 6 psi, and E of brass is 15 into 10 to the power 6. When you divide it, it will be 1.99. So N is equal to 1.933. Now if you replace this steel with a material of brass, so area will be increased with N time. So area will increase, area of this will increase N time. So Na of steel will increase. So N into 1.933. So if you replace it, the steel with brass, so you can see that the area, we do not want to change the height, so only breadth of the steel will increase, the height will remain the same. So BT, now the BT is total width of the transform beams. So this 0.4 mm width of brass and this 0.4 mm width of brass will remain same. So total transform breadth of the transform beam will be equal to 0.4, which is over here. Now the only breadth of steel will change, which is equal to 1.933 into breadth of this steel beam, which is 0.75, and rest this 0.4. So now you can see that total breadth of the transform beam has been changed to 2.25. Initially for composite material it was 0.4 plus 0.4 plus 0.75, but now you have transformed this composite beam into a beam of that is purely made up of brass, so the total breadth is changed to this one. So you can see this is 0.4 is the same, 0.4 is the same, only the breadth of steel is changed into 1.45, and total height is also remains the same, because we cannot change the height for given problem. If we change the height, so it will disturb the neutral axis, and the neutral axis is at a distance of 1.5 inch from the base, or from the base. Clear? Total breadth of the transform beam is 2.25 inch. Now you have to find the moment of inertia of this beam. As we know that moment of inertia is equal to b 1 over 12 bh cube plus ad square plus ad square. So in this case the neutral axis is passing through centroid, so d will be equal to 0. So moment of inertia for this rectangular beam will be equal to, transform beam will be equal to 1 over 12 bt h cube. So you can see this is 1 over 12 bt is the breadth of transform beam, which is 2.25 inch, and total height is 3 inch, so 3 cube. So this will give you the second moment of inertia of this transform beam about this neutral axis. Now you will have to find the maximum stresses, and you know that maximum stress is equal to mc over I. You have moment that is given in the problem, so let's check that moment. So in this statement of the problem it was given that a moment of 14 kips is into inch is applied. So moment is also given, moment is 40 kips into inch. C is distance from neutral axis to the topmost or bottommost, so C is also given, and moment of inertia that you have calculated for transform beam is this. So if you calculate it, maximum stress will comes out to be 11.85 KSI. So this maximum moment, this maximum stress is for brass, because this transform beam is converted into purely one material that is made of brass. But actually we have a composite beam that is made of brass and steel. So in order, the stress in brass will remain the same, but in stress, in maximum stress in steel will be equal to n times maximum stress in the brass. So n was 1.933 and maximum stress in brass is 11.85 KSI. So you will multiply it, so you will get maximum stress in the steel is 22.9 KSI. So in this way we have find out the stress in brass as well as in steel. So this was all about how to solve the stresses in composite beam. Now I will mention that if n is equal to, let's say it is equal to E1 over E2. So E2 is smaller, E1 is smaller and E2 is greater. So its value will be less than 1. Clear? So again, in this scenario, if you want to replace, so in that case, n time A will also reduce the area. So again, so you have to, in this case, you have to reduce the area. Rest the area will reduce. So it means that you have to reduce the breadth of the replaced material, and the rest of the steps are same. So this is reason you can also take n is equal to E1 over 2 E2 or E2 over E1, but it is recommended that you should use higher E in the numerator and lower in the denominator. Rest the steps are same. I hope you have now a clear understanding of how to solve or how to find the stresses in composite beams. Now we will move toward another example of composite beam, that is reinforced concrete beam. So you might have heard about this concrete beams that are used in construction industries or in for building homes. So in such type of beams, there are two materials used. One is concrete, that is acting as a matrix, and other one is steel rods. You can see these small steel rods, and that is acting as a fiber or reinforcing component. So let we have a reinforced concrete beam that is having breadth B and height D. Now this height D is from the topmost to the center of these rods, that is given as D. Now we know that the concrete that is very it show resist to the compression very well. Clear? Stress concrete is good in compressive stresses, but it does not bear the tensile stresses. Under tensile loading it breaks, but under compression it offer good resistance. On other hand, these steel rods that are very good under the tensile load, clear, and it is not good in compression. So in concrete beam we use the concrete in that portion where there is compressive stress, and in the beam where the tensile load is maximum, so we use the steel rods. Clear? So concrete beam subjected to bendings are reinforced by steel. So actually if it bends like that, so usually the steel rods are placed in that area where there is a tension, and where there is a compression, only concrete is available. So while designing the reinforced concrete beam, we always place the steel rods in such a place that is under the tension. So if we can also place the steel rod over above place, but we will see to the condition that if whether the above portion about the neutral axis is in tensile or below. If above is in tension, so you have to place this steel rod above the neutral axis. But generally, they are placed below the neutral axis because the beam, when bent like this, will have a tension in the lower portion below the neutral axis. So we will see in this topic that how to solve or how to find the stresses in reinforced concrete beam. The steel rods carry the entire tensile load below the neutral surface while concrete takes the compressive load. The upper part of the concrete beam carries the compressive load. So this is the composite beam or reinforced concrete beam. So we will see how to transform this beam how we will transform this beam into a transformed section. Clear? So in transform section, the cross-sectional area of the steel is AS and is replaced by equivalent area NA, where E is equal to E of steel over EC. Now you can see that what we will do, the same thing is that we have to find out E, and E is equal to, as modulus of elasticity of steel is greater than concrete, so N is equal to ES over EC. So this is the value of N. Clear? Now the diameter of this steel rod or area of this steel rod is, let me zoom it also. If A is the area of steel, AS is the area of steel, and we know that is equal to pi by 4 D square. Clear? So now you can see there are three steel rods are available, so that total area of this steel rod will be equal to N times. N is the number of steels. Clear? So it is replaced by equivalent area AS. So total NS is the total steel rod. Clear? This is total cross-sectional area of the rod. Total area of the steel will be equal to N times. N is the number of steel rods that are used. So you will get ATS. Now, what will you do in, as N is equal, N will be some value that will be greater than 1. So the total area of the steel rod, if you want to replace the steel, so total area of the steel rod will be N time of A steel. So it is NAS. Now let this beam is transformed into two sections. The first one, let this is the first portion that is about the neutral axis that must be concrete. This is, let this is the portion in concrete about the neutral axis. Again, this steps is used in order to find the centroidal axis or neutral axis, because in such type of composite material it is difficult to find the neutral axis. So we have to find the neutral axis. So we are going to convert this reinforced concrete beam into transform section. So for that we say that this is the rectangular section that is above the neutral axis, and let this distance of neutral axis from the top place is x. Actually we are interested in to find out x, that where is the where is this centroidal axis actually locates from the top. So let this upper portion is made up of concrete, that is B, and width of this beam, this section is B, and total height is H, X. Now you can see this is a rectangular portion, so its half will be 1 over 2 into X. And the total height from the top till the mid of the this rod is D. So if this is the total, and the lower portion of the steel rod, its area has increased to NS. So the area of the steel rod is increased into NS. Clear? So from top till the mid of this rod, that is total D. So if this is X, so remaining portion will be equal to D minus X, and this is the neutral axis. Clear? So this is how we will find the value of X and then if x is formed, we will find the moment of inertia and then stresses. Remember that in transform section, the cross-sectional area of steel is AS, and that is replaced to the equivalent area NAS, where N is equal to ES over EC. So up till now it is clear. Now we will move further. As we know in our previous lecture that first moment of inertia that is passing through centroid is equal to zero. If you recall the previous lecture of pure bending and its derivation, we have found out that first moment of inertia passing through centroid is equal to zero. So we will use this equation in order to find this location of centroidal axis from the top. So first moment of inertia of this rectangular section is equal to B into its total height is x. So this area multiply by the distance of centroid from the centroid till the mid of first section. So this this is the centroidal axis. So it's and this is the centroid of this section of concrete beam. So its location from centroidal axis is 1 over 2x. So that is equal to area into centroidal distance, which is x by 2. And you have to minus it from the centroidal first moment of inertia of this steel rod. Now we know that the area of this steel rod is total area of this steel rod is NS. So this is NS, and its distance from neutral axis is at a distance of D minus X, and their sum must be equal to zero. This equation is first moment of inertia about neutral axis that must be equal to zero. So this is the first moment of inertia of concrete with respect to neutral axis, and this is the first moment of inertia of steel with respect to neutral axis, and their sum must be equal to zero. So when you solve this, you will get 1 over 2bx square plus n into ax into d minus n a as into d, and this minus minus will be plus, this will be equal to n as into x. Now this is a quadratic equation. So you know the breadth of the beam, clear? You know the area of the steel rod, clear? That the diameter of the steel rod will be given. And you know total depth. Depth is the location of this steel rod from the top of the surface. If you know all these values, so you can easily find the value of x. Now if you find the value of x, you can say that this the neutral axis lies x distance from the top of the beam, and rest you can also find d minus x. If you have total depth, so you can also find d. Once you find this x is the location of centroidal axis, so you can find the stress in the same manner, that is m c over I. So if you know this x will be actually c, clear? You will have m, but you do not have I. So you will, how you will find the moment of inertia of this transform beam? So let me derive it also. As you know that moment of inertia is equal to 1 over 12 bh cube for this portion 1, this concrete. So 1 over 2 bh cube plus ad square, this is for steel. Let if I write steel plus moment of inertia, concrete, this is not steel, this is concrete. Let me erase, let this is for concrete. So for steel that will be also equal to 1 over 12 bh cube plus ad square. So we will see for the both. So I will be equal to, now 1 over 12, what is the breadth of this concrete portion, that is b, what is its height, height is x. So 1 over 12 bx cube plus area is b into x, because the area of concrete will be b into x. So b into x, and what is its d? So distance from centroid to the section centroid, that is 1 over 2. That is 1 over 2, which is will be equal to 1 over 4 x cube. 1 over 4 x cube. Plus, we will come towards steel. Now steel, its height is this height. This is the height of steel rod. Clear? So that will be equal to 1 over 12 bh cube plus area of steel rod as, and d is d minus x, distance of distance from neutral axis to the center, which is d minus x whole square. If I zoom it over here so that you can better understand. So you can see that this is equal to 1 over 12 bx cube plus 1 over 4 bx cube plus 1 over 12 bh cube plus area of steel into d minus x whole square. Now these two terms, 1 over 12 bh cube plus 1 over 4 h cube x cube, they will give you 1 over 3. This I, if I write over here, let me write the whole equation again. This I of transform beam is equal to bx cube over 12 plus bx cube over 4 plus b of steel, height of steel over 12 into n plus n time area of steel into d minus x whole square. This is the area in moment of inertia of transform beam. Let me check over here. One more thing is that for steel you have right to s as well, and for area, a steel area is equal to ns, so you have to multiply n as well. Clear? So this is the same equation that I have written over here. So let's see, is also the breadth. One more thing is that also the breadth of steel bar is increased because area increases due to breadth. So n of b is height of steel. So this equation is now clear. Now we will further solve this equation. So as the steel rod is of having height h, this is small height. Clear? So if you take the cube of the height, it will be further very less value. So this term will, if we neglect this term, is equal to 0. So these two terms will give you bx cube over 3 plus n into as into d minus x whole square. So this is the second moment of inertia of transform beam for concrete beam. Clear? So we will use in this formula. This is how we can find out the second moment of inertia of this transform beam. Once you find out the moment of inertia, so you can have this value, you have this value, you can find the, you can take the y at any distance, so you can find the stress. Similarly, once you find the stress, this will be for concrete, and for steel it will be equal to n time sigma x, because the area is increased, so n will also increase for the steel. So this is how we transform a reinforced composite beam into a transform section, and then we can solve the problem in order to find the maximum stresses in the composite beam. So the idea will be further clear if we solve if we look into the sample problem 4.4. So you can see that a concrete floor slab is reinforced with 5 by 8 inch diameter steel rod. So diameter of steel rod is given, that is 5 by 8 inch. Clear. The modulus of elasticity is 29 for steel. So E of steel is given, that is 29 into 10 raised to power 6 psi. Similarly, the and 3.6 for concrete. So E for concrete is also given, 3.6 into 10 raised to power 6 psi. Clear. With an applied bending moment of 40 kips in a kips into inch for 1 foot width of slab. So you can see for, this moment is given as 40 kips into inch, but it is for 1 foot slab. So you can see that these are the steel rods that are at a distance of 6 inch from each other. So one, as you know, that 1 foot is equal to 12 inch. So you, if you take the center of this rod, from center of this rod to center of this, this is equal to 12 inch, and each which is equal to 1 foot or 1 foot. So moment is given for 1 foot. So you have to determine the maximum stresses in steel and concrete. Also, the distance from top to the center of this rod is given 4. So actually this 4 is actually D. Again, if you have clear understanding of how to tackle with concrete beams, you know these formulas, so you can easily put the values in this in order to find the stresses. But if you do not memorize this formula, it's also okay, because if you have clear concept, you can derive this formula during your problems. So let's start with the problem. First, what we will do, we will transform this concrete beam into transform beam in order to find the x. So what we will do, we will have a concrete portion. This is, let's say, B bread, and this bread will be equal to 12 inch, because we are going to analyze for 1 foot, for 1 foot from the center of this to the center of this rod. So this breadth is 12 inch, and let this height is x. We are interested in to find out the x. Let's say this x is, this is neutral axis, and the area of the steel rod is increased to n into as, and this from this point till the center of this distance is d. So definitely from this to this center, it will be equal to d minus x. Clear? So if you know this figure, you will be definitely able to solve this problem. So you can see that for finding the x value, so what we will do, we will have to find the x, and that is also given in this equation. You can directly use this equation, 1 over 2 bx square plus n into as into x plus n into as into d is equal to 0. So you have b in that, which is 12 inch. You can have area of steel, you can find, because diameter of steel is given. You can also find n, which is equal to e2 or e1. So you have to just put all the values in this equation, so you can find the x. Clear? So let's move toward this problem. So this was a transform section. Now this is the total b, this is x, so this is total 4 inch, so this will be equal to 4 minus x. Now n is equal to e of steel over e of composite concrete. So if you put the value, so n will be equal to 8.06. now the area of the steel, which is equal to pi by 4 d square. D of the steel is given, which is 5 by 8. So when you put 4 pi by 4 into d, so that will be area of one rod. So from this figure, if we can see that this distance is taken from the center of one rod to the center of another rod, So in between these two, there are two total steel rods are. One is this one, half is this one, and half is this one. So total area of steel rod will be equal to 2 times pi by 4 d square, which will give you total area of the steel. So this is the total area of the steel. And when you multiply it with n, so area will increase n times. So that will give you 4.95. So this ns is equal to 4.95 inch square. So the second step is to find out the distance of neutral axis from the top of this, and this is x. And we also note that the formula was 1 over 12 bx cube. Or if you do not, if you are not able to memorize it, so let's see. So the first moment of inertia about x axis is equal to 0. This is first moment of inertia about neutral axis must be equal to 0. So you can see the area of the first section, which is 12 into x. So this is given 12 into x. Now the distance of its center from the centroidal axis. So this central axis is from this distance is x by 2, clear? So this distance is x by 2, which is given over here, minus area of the total area of the steel rod, which is n into s transform, clear? And its distance from the neutral axis, which is 4 minus x. So when you solve this, so x will be comes out to be 1.450 inch. So it means that the neutral axis of this concrete beam lies at a distance of this x is equal to 1.450. It means that this neutral axis lies 1.450 from the top surface. If you have this x value, now you can find the next step is to find the moment of inertia of this transform beam. So you can see that the moment of inertia of the formula for moment of inertia, you can take the formula directly from here, which I have derived here. B 1 over 3 bx cube plus n into as into d minus x. So you can take this value formula from here, or if you want to simply derive it, you can also derive it over here. So let put the formula, let put the value in that formula. We have 1 over 3 bx, first term is this one, 1 over 3 bx cube, 1 over 3 bx cube. So you can see 1 over 3 b is breadth, which is 12, and x is now known, which is 1.45 whole cube. So this is the first term. The second term is n into as into d minus x. So n is also known, area of steel is known, d is known, and x is known. So you have to put the value over here. So this is the area nas, which is given over here, into d minus x. So this is x. So d minus x is equal to 4 minus 1.450, which will be 2.55. So this is 44.4 inch. 4 is the second moment of inertia for this transform beam. Now, what is formula for finding the maximum stresses? So for maximum stresses in concrete beam, we know that sigma c is equal to mci over mc1 over i. So moment is given 40 kips into inch. C1 is distance from neutral axis to the top, which is 1.450, and I is the moment of inertia, which you have calculated over here. So you have to find out the compressive or maximum stress in concrete. Now for steel, it is equal to we have in our previous lecture or previous slide, we have seen that this steel is equal to n times sigma, that is calculated above or in concrete. But now you can see that this equation is only valid when this centroidal or neutral axis is in the half of the total depth. But here you can see the C value for concrete is 1.450, and C value for steel, which is 2.5, there are two different values. So we can see that steel is equal to n time mc2 over I, where n is equal to E2 over E1, which is ES over EC, and that is 8.06. And m is the moment, c2 is the distance from neutral axis to the mid of this steel, and I is the moment of inertia. So when you put it, you will get the stress in steel, which is 18.52. Now you can see, if you want to show them on the beam, our stress distribution in the beam. So this is your portion of the beam that has been transformed, clear? So let's say this is your neutral surface. So from neutral surface, you can see there is a compressive stresses, clear? And there are two rods, they are taking the tensile stresses, clear? And below the portion of neutral axis, this concrete portion is not having importance, because they are just holding these steel rods, and only the tensile loads are taken by these steel rods. So the stress in these steel rods is shown over as sigma s, and that is 18.52. So this is the stress in concrete portion, and this is stress in the steel. So this was all about how to play with the problems like composite beams or concrete beams. I hope you have enjoyed the video. If you have any question, you can ask in comment section. Thank you.